Good afternoon to everyone. This is Sudhanshu Deshmukh from KBT COE. This is an activity given by our Professor Prasad Joshi sir, who is currently teaching us basic electrical engineering. So, this is an activity based on classification of energy resources. So, the contents are types of resources, conventional and non-conventional. So, we'll look on firstly conventional energy resources. So, what do we really mean by conventional resources? Conventional resources of energy can be described as non-renewable resources of energy, which have been used since a long time. Conventional sources of energy are used extensively by mankind, and the magnitude of usage is so high that reserves have got depleted to a great extent. So, nextly, we'll see types of conventional resources. First, coal. Coal helps for various purposes such as heating of house, as fuel for boilers and steam engines, and for the generation of electricity by thermal plants. Second comes oil, most important conventional sources of energy in India. Third comes petroleum and natural gas. Petroleum is the mixture of hydrocarbons like alkanes and cycloalkanes. After refining and purifying crude petroleum, it is available as petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, plastic. Fourth comes fuel woods. The fuel comes from cutting down the forests. Thermal power plant is the fifth. The energy is being generated through heating water into the boiler, and turbine rotates so that there is rotatory motion in the motor and energy generates, that is electricity. Then comes the coal. We'll now learn about what is coal. Coal is the most abundant conventional source of energy, which could last for at least 200 years from now. It is a black brown sedimentary rock. Formation of coal occurs when the remains of plants convert into lignite and then into anthracite. This involves a long process that takes place over a long period of time. Coal helps for various purposes such as heating of the house, as fuel of the boilers and steam engines, as we have learned earlier. It constitutes about 70% of total commercial energy consumption in our country. Then comes the oil. Out of all conventional sources of energy, oil is used abundantly all over. Considering oil is one of the most important conventional sources of energy in India, the resources for same are even smaller. The extraction of oil from deposits is known as oil resources. Third comes the fuel woods. Rural people use the fuel wood for their day-to-day cooking, which comes from natural forests and plantations. The availability of fuel wood has become difficult due to rapid deforestation. We can avoid this problem by planting more trees and degraded forest land, cultivable wasteland. Then comes the non-conventional energy resources. Now we'll learn about what are non-conventional resources. Renewable energy, often referred to as clean energy, comes from natural sources or purposes that are constantly replenished. For example, sunlight or wind keeps shining and blowing even if their availability depends on time and weather. So now we'll see types of non-conventional resources. Firstly comes solar. Solar energy is radiant light and heat from the sun. Wind. The energy is generated through wind. Hydro. The energy is generated through water. Then comes the geothermal. Geothermal energy is heat within the earth. The word geothermal comes from Greek words geo means earth and thermo means heat. Then comes biomass. Biomass is produced by anaerobic digestion with methanogen or anaerobic organisms which digest material inside a closed system, or fermentation of biodegradable materials. Now we'll look on solar energy. Solar power is energy from the sun that is converted into thermal or electrical energy. Solar energy is the cleanest and most abundant renewable energy source available, and the US has some of the richest solar resources in the world. Solar technologies can harness this energy for the variety of uses, including generating electricity, providing light or a comfortable interior environment, and heating water for domestic, commercial or industrial use. Now comes thermal power plant. Thermal energy is energy possessed by an object or system due to movement of particles within the object or the system. Thermal energy is one of the various types of energy where energy can be defined as the ability to do work. Work is the movement of an object due to an applied force. A system is simply a collection of objects within some boundary. Therefore, thermal energy can be described as ability of something to do work due to movements of particles. Because thermal energy is due to movement of particles, it is a type of kinetic energy, which is the energy due to motion. Thermal energy results in something having an internal temperature, and that temperature can be measured, for example, in degrees Celsius, Fahrenheit, or thermometer. The faster the particle moves within an object or system, the higher the temperature that is recorded. Now comes the hydro energy. The amount of precipitation that drains into rivers and streams in a geographic area determines the amount of water available for producing hydropower. Seasonal variations in precipitation and long-term changes in precipitation patterns such as droughts can have large effects on the availability of hydropower production. Because the source of hydroelectric power is water. Hydroelectric power plants are usually located on or near a water source. The volume of the water flow and change in elevation or fall, and often referred to as head from the one point to another, determine the amount of available energy in moving water. In general, the greater the water flow and higher the head, the more electricity is produced in hydropower plant. Now comes geothermal. Geothermal energy is heat within the earth. The word geothermal comes from the Greek words geo means earth and thermo means heat, which you have learnt earlier. Geothermal energy is a renewable energy source because heat is continuously produced inside the earth. People use geothermal heat for bathing, to heat buildings, and to generate electricity. The higher temperature and pressure in Earth's interior cause some rock to melt and solid mantle to behave plastically, resulting in parts of the mantle convecting upward since it is lighter than the surrounding rock, and temperatures at the core mantle boundary can reach over 4000 Celsius. Then comes biomass. Biomass has been used since people first began burning wood to cook food and keep warm. Wood is still the largest biomass energy resources today. Other sources include food crops, grassy and woody plants, residues from agriculture or forestry, oil-rich algae, and the organic components of municipal and industrial wastes. Even the fumes from landfills can be used as biomass energy source. Biomass can be used for fuels, power production, and products that would otherwise be made from fossil fuels. Thank you.